Think fast. Which planet will this particle crash into?
It's not an easy question. If you said the green one, you're right. But it's hard to foresee this trajectory. Moving the starting point only a little bit causes huge changes in behavior. We know for sure that the ones which start sufficiently close to each planet will indeed crash into it, due to a lack of energy to escape that planet's gravity well. But that reasoning only goes so far. It's a mess when we look at points far away from the planets. Now, I won't lead you on. This is not a problem with a clean solution. There's no simple equation here to tell you. I'll just go ahead and spoil the pattern. This plot shows, if an object is dropped at each point, the planet which it would crash into. There's a lot of emergent complexity going on here. But it seems like the complexity is finite. More about that later. Let's watch an object at every point fall. Wow, check that out. We can also move around the planets and see how the plot changes. If their shape is symmetric, so is the plot. We can play around with some different shapes and watch what happens to the design. Let's drop a fourth one in there too and see what happens. And here's a fifth. You might also be surprised at the amount of complexity observed from merely two planets. Now, one thing I found super interesting is the presence of disjoint areas of the same color. What would cause two distinct areas which don't contact each other to drop to the same point? Well, let's look around and see. The answer seems to be that a different region is associated with a different path of winding around the planets to get to the same spot. But I wasn't really able to formalize that idea. Leave a comment if you know of a way. Now, those who know a thing or two about physics could probably tell you that if these gravitational attractors are actually points, then in reality you should never actually crash. You might fall into a stable orbit or spin around chaotically forever, but your kinetic energy wouldn't dissipate enough to cause your orbit to decay into a crash. And that's true. I am slightly cheating here. I'm applying a constant force, a drag per se, which slows the particles down. Let's mess around with this parameter and see what happens. Check that out! Perhaps unsurprisingly, the greater the drag, the less complicated the orbital patterns are, because each particle will just slowly march to the nearest attractor. As drag decreases, the more time the object spends winding in complicated orbits before its fate is decided, and thus the more scrambled the colors get. Let me show you one other parameter which affects the output of the plot. This represents the resolution of time between which we recompute the forces and velocities on the falling objects. As it decreases, the lines between areas become perfectly flat. As it increases, that is, as our simulation loses precision, these ripple-like artifacts are produced. This isn't representative of any physical property, but it was a hurdle for me to overcome while rendering these animations. At first, I wasn't certain whether they were an artifact of imprecise computations or actually part of the diagram. But it seems like they're indeed a mirage. This phenomenon is reminiscent of the three-body problem, where predicting the exact trajectory of each body becomes incredibly complex. We can try the same thing in 3D too. I've picked four tetrahedrally arranged points. This shape in blue is the boundary of the area which converges towards the blue planet. let's move the planets around a little and see what happens. Let's try playing with drag too. Now, let's simplify to just two planets. Check out the radial symmetry. With three planets, you get this nice mirror plane symmetry about the plane all three points lie on. Here's five planets. And here's eight. This has been 2Swap, with music from 6884.